Good evening. All Queenslanders are tonight on notice to come home as soon as possible. In the strongest indication yet, our border could be about to slam shut.
The COVID crisis in New South Wales is worsening with more than 100 new infections. But the news here is far better. More restrictions are lifting.
We haven't had a case infectious in our community now since the 5th of July.
Allowing Queenslanders to ditch the mask from 6 a.m. this Friday.
No restrictions on hospitals and aged care, and I know how hard this has been for people with loved ones in aged care and hospitals.
You'll still need it at the airport and on planes. Restrictions will also be eased at pubs, clubs and cafes. Businesses allowed to go from one person to three people per 4 square metres. Dancing will be allowed again too. You'll still need to check in wherever you go and record guests' details if you're entertaining more than 100 people at your home. Businesses say it can't come soon enough.
At the moment, the only customers we are getting is our strong local base. We're not getting any southerners and we're not even getting the Brisbane people.
But the return to normality hangs on a knife edge. New South Wales COVID outbreak spiralling, recording 112 cases overnight, 34 of them infectious while in the community.
That is the number that we need to see as close to zero as possible before health will advise the government that the lockdown can end.
That's expected to take at least a month, prompting this.
From now, we'll be able to accept anybody over 40 who wants the AstraZeneca.
We are also seeing cases emerge among young adults in the 18 to 20-year-old age group.
There are 63 patients in hospital, 25 under the age of 55, 14 under 35.
Again, dispelling the notion that you are not going to get sick from COVID if you're young.
For now, the Queensland government is comfortably cautious about keeping the border open to New South Wales, but the Premier is warning the situation could change very quickly.
My message to Queenslanders is think seriously, long and hard about what you're doing and if you can, come home.
Also rushing here are 12 NRL teams. They'll arrive by private jet from Wednesday.
This will be definitely our biggest logistical operation and challenge that the game has faced.
Players, their families and NRL staff will stay in 3 exclusive quarantine hotels for 14 days. Teams only allowed to leave for training and games.
There are absolutely no risk at all to the Queensland population.
CEO Andrew Abdo expects the NRL to play out of Queensland for up to the next 2 months, if not the remainder of the season, which makes the possibility of an NRL grand final a real chance. You may remember we saved the AFL season last year and we were rewarded with an AFL grand final. Could the same happen here for the NRL this year? Well, the Premier has welcomed the opportunity to host the NRL grand final here on home soil, but it may be a little bit early to be talking about that, Melissa. It isn't till October 3.
All right, Shannon, thank you. Well, let's go straight now to Lily Greer at the border. Lily, what preparations are going on there?
Well, Melissa, here at Coolangatta, there's no signs of any physical barriers yet, but we know the state government is taking this one day by day, and Queensland Police are prepared to build up those border checkpoints very quickly if they are asked to. Our Chief Health Officer today shedding a bit of light on what might trigger that. Dr. Jeanette Young is looking at New South Wales sewage testing results. She's also looking at the state of their restrictions, but the big one is case locations. If the Delta strain breaks free from those lockdown areas and cases are detected in parts or other parts of regional New South Wales. Tonight, anyone from New South Wales can travel into Queensland here at the border as long as they have an approved travel declaration pass, and they haven't been to any of those hotspot locations in the last 2 weeks. Andrew, tonight the wait is on to see if any of that changes.
Let's see. Lily, thank you.